Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. I've missed you guys. I've literally missed sitting down, talking to you guys, getting glammed up. It's been a while and I hate making excuses, but I'm in school. I'm a full-time nursing student. I'm struggling right now to find time to make YouTube videos with taking care of the house, the family, homework, and school. It's just been a lot. I haven't even been doing my makeup, so I'm so happy right now to have makeup on, to be sitting down here in my room and filming a video for you guys today. I'm probably gonna be messing with my hair a lot in this video just because it's like freshly washed and air dried. And you know, it just kind of like clings onto my face and I just have to keep like, you know, throwing it back. So I was actually feeling kind of sad today because I feel like I'm calling it like a self-identity issue. I just kind of feel like I'm struggling to do the things that I love, do the things that make me happy, do the things that make me me. And one of those things is doing my makeup, filming videos, creating content for you guys. I haven't even been on Instagram. I hardly am on there, period. Like, I don't really see other people's posts and I don't post anything. So I just feel like I'm being consumed by nursing school. And it just makes me sad because my life is literally just nursing school with a little dash of everything else. And it just makes me sad. So it's fall. It's my favorite time of year. It's my time, you know, it's my favorite time to dress up, to do my makeup. I love Halloween. I love creating Halloween makeup looks. I love doing all the fun Halloween things, going to the pumpkin farm. I usually get season passes to the pumpkin farm because I love it that much, so that I can take my kids like whenever I feel like going. And this year with school, I haven't been able to do all those things that I love, and it's just kind of making me a little sad. So that's why today I made it an effort. Like, you know what? I am going to do my makeup and I'm gonna sit down and film a video. I don't care about anything else. This is what I'm gonna do because I need it. Like, I just need it mentally. I need it to help me out, you know. I need to feel better, you know. So honestly, when I tell you guys that I've missed you guys, I have honestly missed you guys, and I am so happy to be sitting here in my room filming this video for you guys. And I appreciate you so much for your patience with me, for being a subscriber, for sticking around, for watching my videos, liking my videos, commenting on my videos. I truly appreciate it, and I'm truly happy to do this, sitting down and filming for you guys, creating content. So that was a super long intro, but anyways, I'm going to share what is in my school backpack. So this is my backpack right here, and I'm gonna show you guys what I keep in it, how I organize myself for school. So I do have a video where I went on a whole search for a backpack. I went to Ross, I went to Burlington, TJ Maxx, looking for a backpack. I needed a big backpack that was gonna fit my laptop in there and then still have room to fit like all the rest of my stuff. So I finally found this one from Steve Madden. So this is what the backpack looks like. It's an olive green color with some black details on it, gold hardware. It's Steve Madden. It has these straps on it that say Steve Madden. I love Steve Madden. It's actually one of my favorite brands. I just really love everything that Steve Madden does. It's totally my style. It's very simple and classy. I really, really like it. So this is a little bit more sportier looking than my style, but I think all backpacks kind of look sporty. And I was trying to find a really fashionable backpack, but they were all way too small or way too heavy, or they couldn't open wide enough. So I stuck with this one and I've been really enjoying it so far. The only thing I don't like is these straps are extremely long for me. This is like as short as they can get, and I'm like not a very big person, so it like hangs like right on my butt and it's kind of uncomfortable. Like, it kind of hurts my back. So I don't know how I can make this smaller, but I need it to be smaller, like the straps to be smaller. But anyways, let's get into what I keep inside. So First of all, I have this little pocket right here on the very outside. And right here, it's really small. I just keep my keys and I have like a little tiny wallet attached to my keys. So they fit in here. So my wallet and my keys fit in here. And that's all I keep in there. And then in this pocket, this is like my most reached pocket. So in here is like all the goodies. So I keep a bag full of pens, highlighters. I have a calculator, just a little simple calculator, Wexford calculator, just for like dosage calculations. Sometimes we have exams and they add a little bit of dosage calculations, like medication calculations. And we're allowed to use a non-scientific calculator during the exams. And then I have a little case that has my headphones in there. Chicle, gum. I always have gum extra, and the spearmint is my favorite. I have them literally all over my house, in my car, everywhere. Here's another little pack. I'm just going through this quickly, and then I'll show you guys in detail. But I have a little stapler. Contact lens re-wetting drops. When your contacts start getting dry because you forget to blink, or they get dry because you're looking up at the board and you know your contacts just get dried out, so you might need that. A little whiteout, what is this called? Corrector, whiteout, you know, whiteout. And then a hand sanitizer. This was actually from e.l.f. They sent that to me in a package one time, and that's all that's in there. So let's go into detail. So I've had this little Ipsy bag for years and years and years, and I love it because it has graffiti all over it. So I feel like it's like the perfect pencil pouch, you know, or like pen pouch, because it's like all colorful. So in here I have highlighters, I have so many different colored pens and all that. So at the end of this video, if you guys are into pens and stationery type things, I am gonna show you guys what is inside of this bag, my favorite pens, and kind of how I use my pens and my highlighters. If you guys want to see that, I'm gonna have that at the end. So first I'm gonna show you guys everything that's inside my backpack, and then I'll show you guys what's inside of my pencil pouch at the end of the video, because that is important to me. I love buying pens and highlighters. Sometimes I like to save my ink and paper, so I print things out at school. So I keep my stapler with me so that I can staple my papers together, because they don't have like a stapler that we can just use. Okay, so first of all, chewing gum helps, you know, like stimulate your brain. It's supposed to like stimulate blood flow to your brain. And also, for me, it helps me with like anxiousness, exam jitters. If you get nervous with an exam, you know, chewing gum can help you like to relax. Also, I clench my jaw when I'm like stressed out or nervous. I clench my jaw, and chewing gum really helps me to prevent myself from clenching my jaw. So I always have gum with me. I use gum when I study, and I also use gum during an exam. Like always, if I have an exam and I'm about to run into class, I'm gonna pull out my pencil, my eraser, and my gum. As a little study hack, smelling the things during an exam that you usually smell or taste during your study time is gonna help you remember. So that's why I always have the same flavored gum. So I chew this gum while I'm studying, and then later when I take my exam, I'll chew this exact same gum so that I can kind of remember. You know how like smells have memory? That type of thing, you know? And then this little pouch is actually from the Dollar Tree. It's just a cute little cheetah print pouch. They had a lot of different designs in there, and I keep my little headphones in here. I personally hate headphones. I just hate having things inside of my ear. It just really bothers me. It makes me feel like really weird. I don't like it. And but I kind of need them for school. I need them for my laptop, and sometimes I have a lot of assignments on my laptop that I have to do, and like it requires me to listen to things. And also I have like virtual labs, and I have to like listen to my patient and talk to my patient. So I got these from Walmart, super inexpensive. I kept the box so I can show you guys. This is called Groove On Wireless Earphones. 7 hours of play time when it's fully charged. You know, it connects Bluetooth. It has like this type of thing. So these actually help to like stay in the ear and feel really comfortable. I think it was like $10 or so, but I actually really, really like those. So I make sure to take them to school with me all the time in my little case. So the next thing is my little side pocket. So I always have a water with me, but I also always have this BlendJet 2 in here. So I actually saw this, you know, it's like all over Instagram, Facebook, everywhere. And if you look it up, you're gonna see those ads everywhere, trust me, like it's pretty annoying. But I actually really, really love this thing. This is my second time purchasing actually, because my other one broke on accident. I was trying to kill a fly and I accidentally knocked it over and it broke. This is glass. It's a portable blender, so I can blend anywhere basically. It's rechargeable and it blends anywhere. So I really, really like this, and I always take it with me because in the mornings when I'm rushing to school, I make protein shakes and I also make green smoothies. So I always bring that with me to school because sometimes you just don't have time to eat, but it's super easy and, like, you know, convenient to have that. Not sponsored, okay? Okay, so now let's get inside. There's like two little pockets in here. There's two little pockets in here. So on this smaller one, I keep two pencils and an eraser in here. I don't keep any pencils in here. I just use these two pencils for when we have exams or quizzes, because it's all like Scantron. You have to fill in the bubble with pencil. So I just use these Ticonderoga pencils. And this little eraser, I've actually had this eraser since the first time I was in nursing school. My friend Jessica gave this to me, and we always had it with us during an exam. We always had like our little routine. We would chew our gum, get our erasers, smell our oranges, because that was another thing we had. And so it just, I don't know, it just kind of reminds me of her, and it reminds me of the struggle of nursing school. But we got through it, we graduated, and here I am again, round two of nursing school. It's just kind of special to me, so I keep that with me. And the reason why I don't keep it in the bag and I keep it in here is because when I am gonna go into a class for an exam, you're supposed to like leave all your stuff by the door. You can't have anything with you. So as soon as I walk into the classroom, I just open my backpack, pull out my pencils, and I sit down. You know, so that way I don't have to be rummaging through my bag looking for my pencils. It's just right there, right away for me to grab and go. And then the other one, the bigger one, is actually where I keep my phone. So it's like the perfect size to just keep your phone in there during class, because you can't have your phones out. So then next is a planner. A planner is a must. I have always been a list maker, a planner. Planners are just really important for me. To keep myself organized and on task. I love doing to-do lists and stuff, but you know, since I'm in full-time, I have four classes, I need to be on track. So I usually write all my assignments out in the monthly, and then in my weeklies, I divide my study time and my assignments, so that way I list it out, so that way I know what I'm gonna do and I know how much time I need to set out in my day for that and stuff like that. So it's actually been very helpful, and it's gonna, especially if you're taking a lot of classes, a planner is a must so that you can keep track of your assignments, because you might have so many assignments due, and a lot of assignments are due on the same day. And so just so you can keep track of your assignments, make sure you turn everything in on time, because every point is needed. So don't miss out on any points, don't miss out on assignments because you forgot. Keep a planner. And I got this planner from Target. This is from a brand called Yao Cheng for Blue Sky. Next is my laptop. I always have to have my laptop with me. Like I said, a lot of my assignments are on here. I can view my PowerPoints. If it's something that's hard to see on the projector, I can see it on my laptop. I got this little protective cover from Amazon. I actually really like it. It's so smooth. It's like a faux marble looking thing. It comes with the bottom and the top, and it also comes with the little keyboard protector. Also very inexpensive. I'll have it linked down below so you guys can see it. But I really like that. I think it's essential because my laptop was getting super dirty. This keeps, you know, crumbs and stuff from getting in there because, you know, I like to snack while I study. And that's all that I currently have in my backpack because I can't fit everything in there. So I told you guys I'm taking 4 classes right now, and I literally have 9 textbooks for this semester. 9 textbooks. That is way too much to be keeping inside of my backpack all the time. Like, literally, I will break my back trying to carry around all these textbooks with all my other stuff. Like, no, no. So I keep it inside of this pineapple bag from the Dollar Tree. I've had this bag, never used it, and I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna stick my books in there. So basically what I do is in the mornings before I go to school, depending on my classes that I'm gonna have for that day, I just pull out the book that I need, and then when I'm done, I put it back into this bag, and that's how I do it. Like, on Wednesdays, I have like, how many books? 4, actually, I have 5 books that I need on Wednesdays for my classes, so sometimes I just leave some in my car, put some into my backpack, and then later after that class is over and I'm gonna go to my next class, I'll just go to my car, get my other book, you know, switch it out, so that way I'm not carrying so many things inside of my backpack because it gets heavy on the shoulders, okay? And my books, you guys, I try to rent them all. That is the best thing to do. Rent them. Don't buy any books because it's expensive. I used to rent a lot from Chegg. And some of them are from Chegg, but I try to go on Amazon. You can get like a Prime student account and all that. And another thing that I used to do in nursing school, because you know, nursing school is expensive. So if you're like a broke college student that's not working, you're trying to save all of your money, this is a tip. I don't know if this is a thing anymore. This is what I used to do years ago when I was in nursing school. But I used to not buy all the books, and I would just go to Barnes & Noble and read the books, study there at Barnes & Noble while I'm there, get a little Starbucks and read the books, and then put the book right back onto the shelf when I was done and come back a couple days later to do it again. So that way I didn't have to buy the book. I would just go to read the book, hang out at Barnes & Noble, study, and that's it. That's how I saved some money. So that's another little tip for you. I don't know if Barnes & Noble, you know, if they still do that. I don't know if they have the plastic wrapping, but I used to do that a lot for like pharmacology books and nursing diagnosis books. Like, I did not want to buy that, so I would just go to Barnes & Noble. I would do my care plans there, you know, jot down my diagnosis and everything, and be on my way. After I choose my books that I need for that day, I also have to choose my folder and journal for that day, because I, like I said, I can't keep everything in there. So I have 4 journals, 4 folders in here, and then I also have an empty folder and loose leaf paper. So whenever I feel like I need loose leaf paper, I just put it inside of that little empty folder and take it with me. This binder is like a 3-ring binder, I mean a 3-inch binder from Walmart. The dividers I actually really like because they're dividers and a folder in one. So this is what the folders look like. They're clear so you can see what's in here. So I really like these. I found these from Target. So I keep my syllabus on the front of every folder. So that way I can see right away what assignments are due, what reading assignments are due. You know, do I have a quiz that week, an exam that week? All of my notebooks are journals. I mean, all of my journals are black. But then I put these cute little glitter stickers on them so that right away I can see, like, oh, this is my nutrition one. Oh, this is my transitions one. Oh, this is my, you know, my health assessment one. And I believe I got these silver stickers either from Walmart or the Dollar Tree. I cannot remember. So that's basically how I try and stay organized. Pull things out when I need them, put them back when I don't need them anymore. And then sometimes, not always, I have days where I have a lab. So I need to carry like my stethoscope and my blood pressure cuff. not in my backpack, but I also carry with me a lunchbox, and I got this from Amazon. So I'll also put a link to my storefront down there so you guys can find this lunchbox. It's from a brand called Flow Fly. They have a lot of different prints. I love the size of it. It's like not too big and not too small. It has like pockets over here. Usually I put my napkins and yeah, see like spoons and forks in there. It also comes with the straps, which I haven't used yet, insulated, and it fits a lot in here. So I try to take my lunch to school, especially on the long days where I'm there for a long time. I do try to take my lunch so that I am not tempted or starving where I have to go out and buy something to eat, because first of all, it's not healthy, it's probably going to be fast food or whatever, and also I'm going to be spending money that I shouldn't have to spend. So I try to pack my lunch the night before, and that way I got something to eat at school. And at school they have like a toaster, a microwave, and a Keurig. So I also take my K-cup with me. I take a mug with me and a little K-cup, and I make my coffee at school too because it's so tempting. Like literally my school is by so many restaurants that it's like so tempting to just go. Don't go spend money. Stay at school. That way I save myself some time from driving. I save some gas. I save money. So I just stay at school, eat at school, study at school in between classes, and like that. So yeah, that's everything that I keep inside of my school backpack. And if you guys have any questions about nursing school or have any video ideas about nursing school, let me know in the comments. I will try to please you. If you guys are wondering like, why the heck are you in nursing school again? I thought you were already a nurse. What? I'm confused. You know, just let me know what you want to know in the comments below. I'll answer it for you. Also, I can't wear any nails anymore. It's so sad. That's why I'm telling you I have like a self-identity issue, because I can't, like, I don't have any time to do my makeup. Also, we have to wear a mask at school all the time, so it's like no point in wearing makeup. I can't have my nails did. It's just like, it's a lot, you guys. It's a lot. Trust me, I am so happy to be here with my makeup on, my fall makeup on, and filming this video for you guys. I am so happy to be here. So if you guys enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate if you guys give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Also leave me a comment below. And also stay tuned if you guys want to see what I keep inside of my little pencil pouch, because I love pens and highlighters and color coding everything. I am a very visual learner as well as like a tactile learner. I like touch, hands on, and physically writing my notes helps me memorize. It helps me retain the things. I am not a very tech person. I'm still very much a pen and paper person. That's why I have my journals. I don't keep everything on my laptop. I just do my assignments on my laptop and stuff. So writing out my notes, color coding them is really helpful. I also, I don't know if you noticed, inside of my planner, I color code my classes. So each class is a different color, and that helps me to visualize my planner and easily see what assignment is due on which day. So you guys want to see what I keep inside of here, then keep on watching this video. If you don't care, then that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I appreciate you guys watching, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Bye. So this is a quick little stationery haul of stuff that I've picked up for school. I chose this one because they had a lot of colors. I wanted purple because I already have these highlighters. I love using them, but they don't have a purple, and I wanted a purple just because I need more colors. I never tried them out. I don't know if I'm gonna like them. Okay, so I'll check that in a moment. Also got blue pens. So these are the blue pens that I've been using for school. Bic Atlantis. This is a 1 millimeter ballpoint pen. I love ballpoint pens. I love how it just feels, how it like writes, and it feels so smooth. So I really like these, and I specifically like blue because years ago, when it was my first go around at nursing school, my friend and I were looking up ways to study, and supposedly studying and writing notes in blue pen help you to remember it. Anything that's school related, I always use blue pen. So they were out of stock for this specific pen. So I found these at the Dollar Tree. It's a 2-pack of Paper Mate gel pens. I'm not such a big fan of gel pens, but I figured they're a dollar, so I'll just get it. These are gel 0.7 millimeter pen. And since I didn't think I was gonna like those very, very much, I also got these from the Dollar Tree. These are also ballpoint pen, 1 millimeter. Blue pens are a must for me. But then I also decided to pick up some colorful pens. So I got these from the Dollar Tree. It's like the same as these, just colorful. And I got those because I want to color coordinate my planner according to my classes. So then I also found these gel pens, which I thought were super cute. I love the colors. So it each comes with 4 different colors. It says that these are quick drying gel inks, medium point. So hopefully I can write, since it's quick drying, hopefully I can write with in my planner with those and it won't bleed through. These ones are ballpoint pens, so they should not bleed through. These look like fall colors. And I also have a red pen because sometimes when we have to do corrections or anything on the Scantrons, the professors say to circle it in red pen so it's easy for them to see just in case there's any mistakes. So I just opened up these highlighters and they're gel highlighters. Like literally, this is gel. This is how it writes, but it smears because it's literally like gel. So you see there's like some little crumbling there. When you put your finger on it, it can smear. So I do not like these, do not recommend them. I mean, I guess it's cool, but this is gonna make a smeary mess in my notes. I love how bright it is, but I don't know. I wanted markers, not gels. Look at this. Oh my God, it's so thick. Do you see that? Oh, no. I really wanted the purple, and look at that. That's ugly. So, not going to use these. I'm going to have to search for a different pack of highlighters that has a purple in it.